Hi, welcome to Fixed by Doc. And today we are standing in the middle of the creek that runs from our spring that flows south to north. This is not to be confused with the creek that goes from west to east that divides our field from our forest. That's a different creek. This is the one where we get our water from. And you see a white pipeline right here. That is our old pipeline that goes to our old water tank system. And the orange line is the new line that's going to our ram pump that we're installing today. And all the chickens are like curious as to what's going on. They all came down here to inspect and supervise and manage the installation, I suppose. What's up, chickens? You're kicking up a lot of dust for me. So here is the spring. One day we're going to come down here and we're actually going to dig this all out and make it a little bit better. But for now it is flowing quite nicely, getting close to 6 to 8 gallons per minute flowing out of here as it is. And it has potential to do closer to 10 gallons per minute if we dug it all out and put a pipe in and stuff. Which maybe next summer we'll look into doing that. And if you remember, not long ago we dug this all out, and we dug this here out. We put in a cul-de-sac, we filled it with pea gravel, and we put in that line there. This bag right here we just stuck in to seal off
over that pipe.
To seal off the pipe right here, because we don't want any water going into the new pipe. So we just stuck a bag over it and a rubber band on there, so it's not a piece of trash just floating in here. It's just being used as a plug at the moment. So what we did was took a screw cap, put it in there, and a screw cap, put it on this end with a rubber washer and a steel washer, screwed them together, made a hole through the wall 3/4 inch. And by screw cap, I mean it's the hose, male hose adapter on this side, a female hose adapter on the other side, screwed together, pinching the wall between them with a piece of rubber and a water seal, and it doesn't leak at all. No leaking or anything around here. The water you see there is the overflow from the cul-de-sac dam. And there you go. So when we turn this one on, we will most likely terminate this one, stop this one from flowing, because I don't know if there's enough water with this current setup, if there's enough water to run both pipelines, but we will find out.
Well, the ram pump is going to slow down the flow.
Yeah, the ram pump will slow down the flow on it too, so we'll see. Once it all gets settled and flowing, we'll find out. It would be nice if there's enough water to run both pipelines, which I'm hoping for, but if not, it's not that detrimental, because if there's enough water to run both pipelines, then this pipeline feeds the original 300 gallon tank, and that keeps flowing as it has been for the last 3 years. And this one will feed the 30 gallon tank inside the house, which overflows and feeds the 300 gallon tank behind the house, which gives us a total of 630 gallons of water. 330 at the house and another 300 down by the green water, or by the gray water evaporation greenhouse. So we have two different storage areas. If it doesn't provide enough water for both lines, then we turn off that line, and this line will go to the cabin, where it has a 30 gallon tank which overflows into the first 300, and then that 300 will overflow into the second 300, still giving us 630 gallons. Just a matter of which way we do it. Will we run everything off of this line, or can we run both lines at the same time? That's what we'll end up finding out one way or another today. But we do know for sure that the ram pump works, because we saw the last video, and we know that it's going to pump it up to the house. So hopefully everything is good to go. Here's a walkthrough of the line as far as I can go coming down this way. Here's the little bridge work that's set up for the animals to cross. And then there goes down the line on down there. So we're gonna go get the ram pump and hook it up down there. And then we gotta start gluing together the pipe And once we get the pipe all glued together, then we can turn the ram pump on. And we'll probably show you bits and pieces of us gluing the pipe together. So we'll come back to you in a few minutes. Okay, so this is the existing pipeline going to the house. It runs up to the house. The big one there is the gray water coming down. And this is the stand pipe for the gray water tank, which is this tank right here. And that's the stand pipe for it. And then that tire there is where you go in, and there's a big screw-on cap, just like the other water tank that you saw, that allows you to get inside the tank if you need to. And then that pipeline down there runs off into the Greenwater Gray House, the Greywater Greenhouse, which evaporates the gray water. Can't say that right, too many G's. But anyhow, this is the standpipe for that, that allows air to suck into the tank when it's flowing down that pipeline. But this pipeline here, the little half-inch one, has a cap on it right now. It's been on there so that nothing can get inside of it. It just pops right off. That's going to be glued onto the pipeline that we are establishing today, which will is here, running off down there, and where Addy is, going off to the creek for connecting to the ram pump. This pipeline right here, which the cap got knocked off, but this goes to the spring water tank, which is underneath that set right there. These right here are just spare pipes, part of the pipeline we're laying. So the original spring line is right there, which is gravity fed from shrinking pipes to build up pressure, and it brings up the water up to the tank that's buried right here. And then that hose right there is the overflow, which goes down to where all those spring bottles are, that where we fill it, and then it goes off to the creek, back to the creek. So this 300 gallon tank right here is full of spring water, and the separate 300 gallon tank is full of, well, it's actually empty because our gray water evaporation system works pretty well. So it's just a holding tank for in winter when things slow down a bit, we have the ability to store gray water if we need to. So this pipeline here comes off of the bottom of the spring tank, where we can turn on the bottom valve and water will fill up to the top of, level out to the top of this pipe here, and we can attach a pump here and pump water out if we need it to. But we've never actually used it. We installed it as one of those just in case things that we've never actually had to use. So, but anyhow, we're gonna start gluing on the couplers and start gluing this pipeline in onto this pipeline now. And again, I want to point out to Herbster Place One and his family, thank you for digging the trench that these two pipelines are buried in. Thanks to him and his family, we were able to get that trench dug and get them into place. So, and thanks to Land the House, Seth, for his blueprints on how to do the ram pump,
which isn't actually in screen.
Which isn't in screen, but it is sitting over there on top of the compost bin, right there, and that's going in very shortly. So it's a a compilation of all my friends coming together and helping to get this working and get this system working and coming together. And all right, so we're gonna go take a walk here and show you the layout of the pipeline real quick. The ideal layout of the pipeline. Now, once we start gluing it together, we may not stick to this plan, but hopefully it'll go this route. So it's gonna come there. It's not gonna go the same route, because the same route as the other one, because the other one is a shrinking pipe for a pressurized system. This one's going a different route because it's a ram pump system. So It's coming around this way. We're making it a bit shorter line. And coming around through here. Coming down, cut through there, and it kind of levels out. It's going to have a few feet of drop after the ram pump. And goes up and right. See if I can get over there. You can see the brown hose right there and the white end of the pipe right there. That's where the ram pump's going to go in. And our chickens are still over there harassing me and investigating, supervising. So, all right, let's get this going and we'll come back to you shortly. There's some spare pipe in case we need it. All right, so let's check everything. We got snagged on the fence. Okay, there we go. So we got the valve is on, so the water will flow up to the house. And the sink is off. The tank is on for the overflow to here. And I checked inside the house already. So the water should flow into the tank inside the house with no trouble. The overflow should flow out to here with no trouble. It should flow into here with no trouble. This is currently off, so we can have up to 300 gallons of storage in here. It's currently off at the moment, but we won't have any issue. It'll be a long time before the 30 gallons inside the house fills, and then the 300 gallons outside the house fills. It'll be a couple of, maybe a day and a half before that's full. So it's not gonna be an issue. Let's walk the pipeline that we just glued together. Slightly varies from what we showed you initially. Got it glued here. I was thinking maybe we should put a union in here, but we can always come back and do that later. Not that big of a deal. And I was also thinking, if we could afford it, and if somebody has the money to do so, maybe, like, if you're going to duplicate what we're doing and you had the money to do so, every joint would be cool to have a union in. Then if you ever had a failure with a pipe section, you just take the union and take that pipe section out. So
I think that might be a little bit too much money for me to spend on the convenience of just doing that. I mean, they do make those quick fittings now, too. Those Shark Bite, whatever fittings.
The Shark Bite quick fittings would also be good. I don't think, I don't know that I trust the shark bites, but anyhow, it comes down through here. We went up and over. It's kind of a little squiggly. It'd be nice if all our pipe was straight, but it's, we've had it for quite a while and it kind of developed a curve in it. Although the curve's played out well for here. It comes down here. And there's the old pipeline, which is still currently in use. And here's the new one, right there. Get out of Addie's way. The new one's on the left, old one is on the right. There's no water running through it at the moment. There is water running through the one on the right, but not the one on the left. And here's the ram pump. Oh, I forgot to grab the zip tie.
I brought string. I didn't know where the zip tie is.
They're in the outdoor sink, so.
I have the string here. Oh,
because we didn't have enough rocks to pile up to keep it stable. Well, I was going to, we stuck a pipe down into the ground there, and we were going to, I cut a notch right there to run a zip tie around, but I forgot to bring it down with me. Maddie's gonna try to stick a string in there.
Maybe of course, it's the 50-50 chance it's trying to go the other way. There we go.
Alright. And if you wrap it and tie it around underneath the cap, it should stick. So, it doesn't have to be super strong. It just has to hold it upright.
A little bit of support. Is that a square knot? It is good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't sure I was going to make it
pull it a little tighter.
Sure.
No, just the knot. Just pull the entails of the knot tight. The knot was loose. There you go. Okay, I currently have the line going to the house off and the line coming to the pump off, but the hose coming in is currently, there's no water in this hose either because Addie's got it capped off with a plastic bag over the end as well.
And a rubber band. It's high tech.
And a rubber band, yep. So what I need to do right now is when I turn the camera off, I'm going to pull my wrench and I'm going to tighten this up here. Just give it a couple turn, or like a half a turn on there with the wrench so it's nice and tight.
Do you want me to just hold the camera while you do that?
Okay. There you go. I really need to throw away these blue ones. Okay, there we go.
Let go, let go. Good wrench.
It doesn't grab when you want it to grab, and it doesn't let go when you don't want it to let go.
Maybe
you want
it just needs a bit of lube.
Yeah.
Do you want me to go and just open the plastic bag so you can stay here and poke it, or?
Well, I still got to put the netting and stuff around it.
Okay.
So let's go and record
Journey
that.
Along to this.
Want to take those?
Sure.
And
where did you go back in my pocket?
Got to walk up the line here.
You might want to go up to the left and go around that jump.
Nah, we like to get stabby stabbed.
There's roses up there too, I know
that. Yeah. All kinds of things that stabby stab you. So the hose line goes up there and comes down through here underneath the logs and stuff. And then there's a little bridge work here. Whoa! So you can get out of here. There we go. For Addie to come over. Spider webs?
Yeah, but it's already jacked up, so.
Mm-hmm. Ah, sorry about the camera work. But there you go. Okay. This is called a
lint sock.
Lint sock.
Which I think is one of my favorite words.
One end is sewn up, so stuff can't get in it. The other end is open. Basically what we're gonna do, stretch this end over the hose here. As I pull this off, this hose is gonna fill with a lot of water.
Do you have a zip tie?
Yep.
Okay.
Comes with one.
Okay.
It's actually one of those zip ties with the little click on it that makes it removable.
Oh, sweet. Those are cool. I've always thought that they should always have those on the zip tie because, I mean, usually, most of the time, you want to be able to remove it without having to wipe it.
That is ice cold water.
Nah.
It's like,
probably in the 60s.
It feels like it's in the 30s. We should put a thermometer in there and find out. Bird, that's cold. There's a whole lot of air in this line right now. So when I open up the end, the other end, it'll should all burp. But we don't want air in this end of the line, so we don't put a vent. Like if I had a standpipe right here to let the air out, we don't want one on this end of the line. You want this?
Sure. Oh, I mean, like, I'll carry it for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go down to the... back down to the ram pump. And... see what we got going on. We'll have to cut ourselves a little path to come down here eventually. Okay. Alright. That side's turned off. This side's turning on. There it goes. It's pressurizing.
Do you want the other end open?
No, you gotta pressure. You gotta get it to build pressure first.
Okay.
Now it is ready. Now we turn this side on.
Watch the
quarter turn. And just takes a minute. There's a lot of line that it's got to fill and push up. So you just got to do this a few times. Eventually it'll start doing it on its own. See, it's building up pressure now when it starts squirting. If we had a pressure gauge on here, we'd be able to see for ourselves what it is.
But not necessary. I
didn't understand the part of the thing where it showed how to put the pressure gauge in. So you don't need a pressure gauge.
Down.
And then it just runs out like that. The point is that it builds pressure between these two, builds pressure in the tank, and eventually it pushes it all the way up the hill.
Okay.
We have almost 200 feet of pipe,
it's
got to fill and go. So it's going to take a while. Handles too, so I'm gonna have to play and tweak with the
camera
with the handles and stuff, and then we'll come back to you in a little bit. Alright, so it seems to be going good now. It was a little temperamental, took a little adjusting and messing around with, but we got it. It's just a hair over a quarter turn on, just slightly shy of halfway on.
But you can see it's working on its own. The input valve is all the way on. And how's it up there? Okay. So it's sustaining up there? And you only have the orange pipe on? Okay, we had to turn off the gravity feed pipeline, which is the white pipeline, because there wasn't enough water to fill both pipelines. What's that? Yeah, it was draining our reservoir too fast, our spring reservoir. So we only had enough supply coming out of the spring to fill one or the other. Well, basically one and a half of them. So we are running just the ram pump line at the moment, and the gravity feed line is actually turned off. But that's okay, because the ram pump feed line should supply enough water to fill all the tanks in an overflow, inline overflow feed system. So we shouldn't need the gravity feed system anymore at all. In fact, the ram pump system was being built to replace that anyway. We will keep the gravity feed system in line and installed as a backup system, because there's basically no moving parts whatsoever in that system. In case the ram pump should ever fail, or something should happen and the hose line fails, or this line system fails, we'll always have a backup line here. And or if the spring ever, we ever get around to digging the spring out and making it bigger and flow better, then we'll do that. And for whatever reason may pop up in the future, we'll keep that second line in place. You never know what we might need it for. But it seems to be working, so we're gonna cut the camera off here, run up to the house, and see what it looks like in the house. Hopefully the house isn't flooding out, and everything up at the house end is working just fine. All right, we're in the house, and I don't know if you can see it in there. There's water running into the house, filling the tank. Yay! And how much water do we have in there so far? Got about an inch of water on the bottom so far. So it's going to take a while to fill this 30-gallon tank. But no leaks. And you just get down in there. Sure, you can hear it. It's kind of hard to see down. But it is working. So, alright, we'll come back to you in a little while when the tank is full.